this
planet. Prince Harvey, Glasgow! Hear me! Yes, Glasgow! Welcome to the Scottish Vaccine Injured Group! The place, the only place that's telling the truth is on this stage, right here, right now! You will not see these people in the mainstream media! You will not see them on social media! Why? All these people that are sitting here, they all take the vaccine and they've all been left to rot. So you know what, Glasgow? Let's give them a voice and bring the noise.
Thank you, because it's only because of you that this has happened. People like John and myself and all the other vaccine injured and the bereaved can shout all day. But if you don't listen, you're wasting our time. So thank you so much, because you are the people that's made this possible. It's been a long journey for us for 2 years. For those that don't know me, I'll quickly tell you, my name's Alec Mitchell. And as you can clearly see, I'm vaccine injured. The AstraZeneca vaccine gave me a wonderful condition called VIT, amputation and a couple other things. And I'm here to tell you that it's time to stop this. Because there's 446 of me in the UK. With 81 fatalities. I'm sorry, that's 81 families that have lost something precious to them, and I should be with them. I can only say that this is making a difference. I couldn't tell you that I was taking part in the legal action against AstraZeneca. Now I can. I'll see you in court, AstraZeneca.
I'm Callie, I'm 37 and I'm from Edinburgh, and I am one of the vaccine injured. My injury began September 21 and I took Moderna. Unfortunately for me, it ruined my life. I was training every day. I was working in a boxing gym as an instructor. Now I can barely get out of my bed and look after my two young children. Who wants to live like that? Certainly not me. To be honest with you, it began with tremors and seizures and I kind of, at the time, didn't try to ignore it, but I tried to sort of believe that this wasn't happening to me until my 12-year-old daughter was extremely worried and thought that I needed an ambulance. Those symptoms continued on and my body started to fail, my joints started to go, my memory started to go, brain fog, started to have seizures, tremors. But I pushed through every single day because I believed that I would get to the end of it. My GP actually was really good. She understood very quickly that this was absolutely not normal for somebody like myself. And she did believe at the very beginning it was vaccine induced. She put in my referrals, and as you know, referrals take a long, long time, and by that point it was too late. I was jogging up a hill one day, I had a facial collapse like I'd had a stroke, I barely made it to the bottom of the hill with my sister. That journey then continued on to rheumatology, where I was then diagnosed with rheumatoid arthritis and lupus. As you can understand, having young children, this absolutely devastated me. My children are my absolute life. I lost my parents at a very young age in an accident that killed them and took them from me. I do not want to leave my children parentless. Do you understand me? This is not something that we should be going through day to day or for the rest of our life.
I've been fitting well my whole life with no underlying health conditions. When I went to see a doctor about this, they quoted me a year to be seen by rheumatology. A whole year to be left in this critical condition. I can't even use words to describe the pain I was in. In December, they then put a label to my symptoms and diagnosed me with seropositive inflammatory rheumatoid arthritis. I knew that they didn't actually know what this was. I was then forced to have my booster and pneumonia jab before I was allowed to start any treatment. I was told I had a seriously nasty disease out of nowhere and is now incurable, and to be on these intensive medications for the rest of my life. This didn't feel right to me. Over time, I found thousands of others in very similar situations. Everything started to add up. After seeing another rheumatologist, this was actually confirmed this is a vaccine injury, and another doctor also confirmed this as well.
This gentleman is not just an ordinary doctor. This is a very special doctor, as many doctors are. This man, in 2020, was one of the first doctors to treat his patients with hydrochloride.
and the US government decided to try and shut him down. He's still here. He gets better. This man invented a drug for open wounds, and the FDA approved it. 8 years it took him. Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Richard Urso. Thank you.
Does everybody here understand what's happened, that we've been fed a bunch of lies? You trust the NHS?
No!
You trust AstraZeneca?
No!
Moderna?
No!
Pfizer?
No!
All liars? Are you going to be quiet?
No!
We have to rise up, because they want us to be victims. They want us to be hopeless. They want us to despair. Are you hopeless? Are you despair? Or do you believe in freedom? If you want to know something, this vaccine is one of the worst of all times. Why do I say that? First of all, it's a genetic therapy. I invented an FDA-approved drug. It's a biologic. This is another biologic agent. It took 8 years for us to get it passed just to get the production down. Do you think the production on a new drug that's never been made before and anything bigger than a blender can be made in 4 or 5 months? Is that possible? It's not possible. Guess who's finding this out for us? The head of the Human Genome Project, Kevin McKiernan. Kevin McKiernan's doing the work on this. The thing is so contaminated with DNA and other plasmid and other fragments, and we're presenting that data. Have you heard this on the Trusted News Initiative at all?
No!
Do you trust the Trusted News Initiative?
No!
Can't even get the words out of my mouth. And I think in general, like I said before, what we're seeing now is we have a controlled media that wants us to feel victimized. Are you victimized? Or are you going to stand up? Thank you so much for coming out today. What great support. You guys are fantastic. I can't believe how well educated you all are. And I think in general, one thing I want to say is, I think the spirit I think of when I think of Scotland, I just can't help but believe that the Scottish people are going to be locked down. Freedom! Freedom!
I had to go to rehab unit for 6 weeks to learn how to walk again, how to use my hands. It was horrific, horrific. Still is. I'm here today. John's given me a voice. He's gave me this voice today to stand up for all these vaccine injured people behind me. I'm one of them as well. But these guys are amazing. That guy Adam as well, very ill. He stood here today, told his story. John, Alex, Ruth, they were the first guys I met once I found out I was vaccinated.
It's been very hard 3 years for the whole world. The truth is coming out, and it's our job to make sure the truth is heard all over the world. So Scotland, make the noise and make them hear you. I can tell you that we hear you. Freedom is our birthright, never forget that. And it's very important for all of our voices to be heard. And it's important that we stand together for our children.
This doctor was made in Scotland. It was that early experience in your beautiful country that shaped me to be the doctor who I am today. Now, the NHS is failing to even acknowledge and turning their back on another public health crisis, a pandemic of the vaccine injury. Many of you gathered here today have suffered immeasurably, and if it's not you, then it's a friend or family member that has been a victim of the COVID vaccines. Many, like my father, have even died as a result of being deceived into taking a vaccine that the overwhelming evidence now reveals should likely never have been injected into a single human in the first place.
So we're shouting it out, streets of Glasgow, listen to us. If you think you have been injured by this vaccine, we're here to support you. Please, speak to us.
Well, I want to ask you, we all must join together to stop these evil people. Because ask yourself, if we don't join together now, and we ignore people like me and what they've done to people like me, what's next? We're in a fight here. Let's be honest, we're in a fight. We're in a fight. We're in a fight for the children and future generations. I want you to go away from here today, and I know you already know this, but I want you to ask yourself what you stand for as people, as individuals, what your values are. Because I tell you what, they are people for the people. You are the real people. You are the real people. You are the people that make this country, who welcome me. You are the people that make this place and make this city. Scottish people are special. You've got real strength and character. You've got values and morals these people will never have. They can't buy what you are with your money. They can't buy it. They wish they could, but they can't. So I ask you, Scotland, stand together, be brave, be strong, and be unbreakable.
We need your help, we need your voices, and we need you to continue sharing our stories. We want to win this fight, and we can't do it without you.
If you don't know how strong you are, that's all you've got.